Okay, so tempo. Tempo is basically how quickly you are moving through the exercise. So how quickly the barbell or the dumbbells are going to be moving. Tempo is always written in a four-digit number, and it's always in the same order, no matter how what movement is actually being performed. So the first number is the lowering of the barbell, for example. Second number is whether there's going to be a pause. Third number, the return, the speed that you're returning, and whether there's going to be a pause at the top. So if we use this as a demonstration for a squat, like a back squat, you'd be lowering down the barbell for 4 seconds. You wouldn't pause at the bottom. You'd come up with control for 1 second, reorganize at the top, and then come down and repeat that. So that would be a 4-0-1-0 tempo. Now, if you were doing a shoulder press where the barbell is going to start on the shoulder, it would still be expressed as a 4-0-1-0, but you'd start with a 1, pressing the barbell up, no pause at the top, and then a 1, 2, 3, 4 lower, no pause, press again. So the first number is always the lowering contraction, pause at the bottom, the return, and then the pause at the top. Now, tempo can be written in a variety of ways depending on what the stimulus of the workout is. So on this one, if we were to again look at squats, we would do 3 seconds down. We would pause at the bottom of the squat for 2 seconds before returning under control for 1 second. Again, you've also got a higher eccentric, so have a 5-0-X-0. So very slow eccentric of 5 seconds, no pause at the bottom. The X is to represent speed. We want speed out of the bottom of this. You're looking to power up through that as fast as you can. Now, you may not always feel fast when you press that weight up because it should be difficult still. And then you've got a 3-0-1-1. So this may be, say, on something like a seated row. So you'd be doing a contraction of 1, holding in place for 1, and then 3 seconds. Back into that movement. So there's various ways that we can use tempo depending on whether you're what kind of programming that you're on, and it's going to vary, but always try to stick to the tempo, because the way that the program has been written is to build in this tempo and this speed. Any questions?